This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. This strong claims like must come from should be referenced and qualified needs additional citations for verification. Please help improve this article by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. May 2010. Learn how and when to remove this template message. A fair trade certification is a product certification within the market-based movement fair trade. The most widely used fair trade certification is FLO Internationals, the international fair trade certification mark, used in Europe, Africa, Asia, Australia and New Zealand. Fair Trade Certified Mark is the North American equivalent of the International Fair Trade Certification Mark. As of January 2011, there were over 1,000 companies certified to the FLO International certification and a further 1,000 or so certified to other ethical and fair trade certification schemes around the world. The Fair Trade International certification system covers a wide range of products, including banana, coffee, cocoa, cotton, cane sugar, flowers and plants, honey, dried fruit, fruit juices, herbs, spices, tea, nuts and vegetables. These commodities have different locations of production and number of farmers and workers covered for production and distribution contents. 1. How it works. 2. Fair trade standards. 21. Small producer organizations. 22. Hired labor. 23. Trade standards. 3. Fair trade pricing. 4. How fair trade measures its impact. 5. Criticisms. 51. Little money reaches the farmers. 52. Fair trade helps the rich to a larger extent. 53. Inefficient marketing system. 6. Other certification and product labeling. 7. References. How it works. Fair trade is a strategy for poverty alleviation and sustainable development, aiming at creating greater equity in the international trading system through trading partnerships with marginalized farmers and craftspeople in developing countries. Social and economic opportunities are created for these producers in a way that more customers are accessible to their products and a better deal is issued in return. The producers have to comply with all the standards laid down by Fair Trade International. In reality, packers in developed countries pay a fee to the Fair Trade Organization for the right to use the Fair Trade Certification logo. Importers of Fair Trade Certified products are required to pay exporters a price higher than the market price of non-Fair Trade Certified products, so as to cover the additional costs used by Fair Trade Certified firms in marketing and inspection. Any surplus after paying these costs must be used for local social, environmental and economic projects. Fair Trade Standards. A t-shirt made from Fair Trade Certified Cotton. Fair Trade Standards are designed to aid the sustainable development of some smaller producers and agricultural workers in third world countries. In order to become certified Fair Trade producers, the cooperatives and their fellow farmers have to strictly comply with the standards laid down by Fair Trade International. FLO Cert, the for-profit side, is responsible for inspecting and certifying producer organizations in more than 70 countries in Europe, Asia, Africa and Latin America. The general standards set for different stakeholders are listed as follows. Small producer organizations. The majority of the members of the organization must be small-scale producers who do not highly depend on hired workers, but run their farm mainly by their own effort. Any profits earned must be equally distributed among the producers. Every member in the organization should have the right to vote in the decision-making process. Hired labor workers possess the right to join an independent union to collectively bargain their working conditions. No forced or child labor. Working conditions have to be equitable for all workers. Salaries must be at least equal or higher than the minimum wage in effect. Safety and health measures must be implemented properly so as to avoid unwanted injuries at work. Trade standards pay a price higher than the fair trade minimum price in order to cover the costs of sustainable production. Pay an additional amount of money that allows producers to invest in development. Sign contracts that assist long-term planning and sustainable production practices. Fair trade pricing. The fair trade system mainly consists of two types of pricing, which are the minimum price and the premium. These are paid to the exporters according to the proportion of output companies are able to sell with the brand Fair Trade Certified, typically ranging from 17% to up to 60% of their turnover. In some cases, the fair trade minimum price is a guaranteed price, as well as the minimum price that must be paid by buyers to Fair Trade Certified producers. producers, it is a floor price that covers producers' average cost of production, aiming at protecting producers from selling their products underpriced. The Fairtrade premium is a sum of money which is paid on top of the payment for the products. Its use is restricted to investment in the producer's business, livelihood, and the socioeconomic development of the workers. The producers have the largest power deciding how these funds are to be spent. How Fairtrade measures its impact. The Fairtrade system has committed to a program of monitoring, evaluation and learning MEL, which aims at generating recommendations and analysis in support of greater effectiveness and impact. Ongoing market progress is monitored by market-facing organizations present in countries where Fairtrade certified products are sold. Market data is consolidated by Fairtrade International on an annual basis. These data are gathered to form a core basis for the understanding of the dynamics of how certification is developing, and how the impacts of Fairtrade are being distributed between producer organizations, geographies and products. Fairtrade's governance bodies also review key results and evaluate regularly in order to improve strategy and decision making. These results are publicized within staff throughout the Fairtrade system and relevant stakeholders for further discussion of findings and recommendations. Criticisms. Little money reaches the farmers. The Fairtrade Foundation does not monitor how much of the extra amount of money paid to exporters reaches the farmers, as the cooperatives incur relatively heavy fees on inspection, certification and marketing. Only a small amount of money is retained for the farmers in general. Fairtrade producers are only able to sell 18% to 37% of their output as Fairtrade certified over years, while the rest are sold as uncertified at the market prices. Fairtrade helps the rich to a larger extent. Fairtrade is profitable for traders in rich countries rather than that in poor countries. In order to qualify as Fairtrade producers, cooperatives must meet the strict standards set by Fairtrade International, implying that their fellow farmers must be quite skillful and educated. However, it is criticized that these farmers are predominantly from poorest countries, thus lacking the power to bargain with the cooperatives. Corruption even occurs in some cases. Inefficient marketing system. There have been complaints that Fairtrade certified products should not be sold through a monopsonist cooperative because it may be inefficient and corruption easily takes place. Fairtrade farmers should have the right to choose the buyer who offers the best price, or switch when their cooperatives are going bankrupt. Other certification and product labelings. The Fair Trade Federation does not certify individual products, but instead evaluates an entire business. The FTO mark, launched in 2004 by World Fair Trade Organization, and identifies registered fair trade organizations. UTS certified as a coffee certification program that has sometimes been dubbed Fair Trade Light. Counter Culture. Direct Trade Certification as a direct trade alternative to the Fair Trade certification. Whole Trade Guarantee, a purchasing initiative launched in 2007 by Whole Foods Market. References. Carrot. List of companies certified to FLO International's Fair Trade certification. Carrot. Elliott, K. 2012. Is My Fair Trade Coffee Really Fair? Trends and Challenges in Fair Trade Certification. Center for Global Development, Policy Paper, pp. 17. Carrot. Fair Trade Federation Org, 2014. Fair Trade Federation International, pp. 8. Fairtrade.net, 2014. Fairtrade International, about, what is Fairtrade. Available at, http://fairtrade.net/what-is-fairtrade.mel. Accessed 26 October 2014. Carat. Fairtrade Minimum Price and Fairtrade Premium Table. 2014. Bonn, Germany, Fairtrade International, pp. 3. Fairtrade.org, 2014. How Fairtrade Monitors and Measures Impact. Available at, http://fairtrade.org/and/what-is-fairtrade/the-impact-of-our-work/how-fairtrade-monitors-and-measures-impact. Carat. Fairtrade.org, 2014. How Fairtrade Monitors and Measures Impact. Available at http://fairtrade.org/and/what-is-fairtrade/the-impact-of-our-work/how-fairtrade-monitors-and-measures-impact. Carat. The Globe and Mail, 2014. Fairtrade Coffee Fails to Help the Poor. British Report finds. Available at http://theglobeandmail.com/report-on-business/international-business/fairtrade-coffee-fails-to-help-the-poor-british-report-finds/article-1885285/. Carat. Marsden, R. 2014. Fairtrade Fails to Help Poor Farmers, Says Damning Investment investigation mail online available at http://dailymail.cook/news/article-263913/fairtrade-fails-help-poor-farmers-damning-investigation-says-profits-sent-help-uganda-ethiopia-not-reach-workforced-mail. Carrot Silla, N2014 Fair Trade is an unjust movement that serves the rich. N. Dongo Samba Silla The Guardian available at http://theguardian.com/global-development/2014/sep/05/fairtrade-unjust-movement-serves-rich-carrot-mendoza, R. Trade Justice Trade Justice Movement Sweatshops Body Shopping World Shop Federations Fair Trade Labeling Organizations International World Fair Trade Organization Network of European World Shops European Fair Trade Association Fine Fair Trade Federation International Resources for Fairer Trade IRFT Certification Fair Trade Certification FLO International Standard Setting and Producer Support FLO Cert Inspection Fair Trade Certified Mark Labeling Initiatives Asociación del Sello de Productos de Comercio Justo Fair Trade Association of Australia and New Zealand Fair Trade Mark Ireland The Fair Trade Foundation Association Max Havelaar France Stichting Max Havelaar Max Havelaar Siftung Switzerland Fair Trade Canada Fair Trade USA formerly Transfair USA Alternative Trading Organizations Alter Eco Artisans Du Monde Café Direct CTM Altromercato Divine Chocolate Equal Exchange Equal Exchange Trading Rainforest Alliance GEPA The Fair Trade Company Handcrafting Justice SERRV International Tradecraft Twin Trading 10,000 Villages Veja Sneakers Campaigns Fair Trade Town List of Fair Trade Settlements Fair Trade Fortnite Make Trade Fair No Sweat World Fair Trade Day Media Black Gold 2006 Film Brewing Justice Book Category, Fair Trade VE Social and Environmental Accountability Ethics and Principles Aarhus Convention Corporate Accountability. Sullivan Principles Transparency Behavioral Social UN Global Compact Social Accounting Double Bottom Line Ethical Positioning Index HIG Index Impact Assessment. Whole Life Cost Environmental Accounting Carbon Accounting Eco Management and Audit Scheme Emission Inventory Environmental Full Cost Accounting. GXP Guidelines Sustainability Reporting Auditing Community-Based Monitoring Environmental. Ethical Consumerism Euthenics Health Impact Assessment Market Governance Mechanism Product Certification Public Participation Social Enterprise Socially Responsible Investing Stakeholder